Good day everyone, and welcome to another episode of Pokemon of the Week. Now in this episode, I am going to be taking a look at the Fire-type starter, Emboar. Now Emboar is one of the Pokemon that is the starters of the 5th generation, and its first form is Tepig, of course. And of course, it can be claimed as a starter in Pokemon Black and White. And apparently, the Pokemon is called the Mega Fire Pig Pokemon. Yeah, okay, I can't really say that that's a good classification. It sounds quite funny, if you honestly ask me. But anyway, moving on to the review. Now, as for Emboar's appearance, I can't say I like this thing a lot. It's alright. I personally think it looks a little bit of a mess. I know that may sound a bit awkward. Yeah, to anyone that does like Emboar's appearance, then fine. But, you know, I just can't say I'm a huge fan of this Pokemon's appearance. It reminds me too much of Rhyperia, if you ask me. I mean, it has almost the same body shape as Rhyperia. And, you know, I just can't say that this thing is amazing on the looks department. So, already we have a bit of a somewhat bad start, but at least it enters the all-right category. It doesn't look horrible, to be fair. So, moving into the stats section of this Pokemon. Now, unfortunately, its speed, defense, and special defense is not what I like to call great. However, it is helped by the fact that it has pretty good hit points, because as you can see right here, it always has a minimum of 330 in HP, so that does give it a nice, decent amount of HP to play about with. So it can be somewhat bulky. Its attack stat is, in my opinion, the best stat it has. It's got a great amount of attacking power, and it can use quite a variety of physical attacks, but we'll come on to those later. And better yet, its special attack stat is actually pretty decent as well, so you can actually make this thing to be either a full-on special attacker, or a mixed sweeper, or pure special attacker. It's completely your choice. So, its type is Fire Fighting. Now, that's not a bad type, but again, I can't really understand what's so fighting about it. I can't really see anything in it that resembles fighting. I mean, also, I find it quite appalling by the fact that we've already got two fire fighting, and they are both previous starters, so I don't see why they have to make this thing a fire fighting type as well. I personally would have much rather it have been just a pure fire type. So, yeah, but despite that, fighting is a pretty good section of the OU metagame, or metagame in general, actually. So, it can be proved useful, and it does learn a lot of good physical special moves. Physical fighting moves, that's right. So anyway, let us move into the next page here. Now, lots to go through here. Its abilities are Blaze and Reckless, hidden ability of course being the Reckless. A Blaze is usable. It can be a bit difficult to use because of the fact that it's not really very fast. Its speed stat is not the best in the world. You could use it in a trick room team quite easily, or you want to build it up to be a curse Emboar. You can do that if you want. As listed, as you can see right here, it does learn curse as a support move, which does help it out in terms of physical defense, especially if you've got max HP to go with it. As for its weaknesses, it's got a few nasty weaknesses because of the fire fighting type. Water, well, that's natural for a fire type, I'm not really going to complain about that. The weakness to ground is kind of nasty because it, moves like Earthquake are used quite commonly. And the weakness to Psychic, it's not a big problem. I don't see Psychic used that much in the standard game, but, you know, it is still a bit of a nasty weakness. As for flying, that is a bit of a big problem as well. But again, it makes sense given the fact that it's a fighting type. This is one of the reasons why I'd rather it have been just a pure fire type, because then it would not have had the weaknesses to Psychic and flying. But on the bright side, it does have a good number of resistances, which are Ice, Grass, Fire, Steel, Bug, and Dark. That is actually a good set of resistances, so it does make up for its weaknesses with its resistances, so I can give it credit on there as an overall basis. As for notable moves, well, there's plenty you can choose from this thing. As I said previously, it learns a lot of physical attacks, and a lot of them have great coverage. If anything, pretty much all of the physical moves it learns are actually usable, and it gets Wild Charge, which really does help out against those water types and those flying types. So it does remedy the weaknesses a bit more. Plus it gets Stone Age, Earthquake. It's basically a standard physical attacker, but it has a lot of coverage. Now the move Heat Crash I want to focus a bit on. This move is usable, but in my honest opinion, I think Flare Blitz works out better, because according to what I've been told by Bulbapedia and such, Heat Crash's highest power is 120, which is on the heaviest Pokemon possible. Whereas other Pokemon, the damage will change, whereas with Flare Blitz, it's always base 120. So unless you simply don't like the Flare Blitz recoil, I would recommend you use Flare Blitz over Heat Crash. Alternatively, there is plenty of other moves you can choose from as well, like Flame Charge to boost your speed, and you can do stuff like that as well. But primarily, Heat Crash and Flare Blitz are its main physical fire moves. Now, the special section is decent. It does learn quite a lot of useful special moves. If you're slapping on a choice specs and using it in a Trick Room team, you can quite easily do that. And it does learn a decent supply of special moves. It gets Grass Knot, Focus Blast, which is of course boosted by Stab, so at least that's something that's good about the fact that it's a part of Fighting type. It gets Overheat and Solar Beam. Of course, only use Solar Beam in the sun, but that's quite easy with how Draught is used with Ninetales now. The support move pool is only has three moves that I think are worth mentioning. Curse I've already talked about, Sunny Day and Will-O-Wisp. Will-O-Wisp is actually very good if you want to build up Emboar to be a defensive variety, so Will-O-Wisp is definitely worth using if you're doing that. So, to be honest, most of the uses that are listed here I have already mentioned. It can learn Flame Charge to boost its bad speed stat, you know, and it's got excellent coverage on physical. So, moving into the last page, which is the downside to this Pokemon. Now, it, of course, the first downside is it has bad base speed. Now, I'm not going to throw this into a big scenario because it can still be used in a Trick Room team, plus it does learn Flame Charge, so I haven't got a huge problem with the bad base speed. And as of course I've always listed here, it's a bit bad on the weaknesses. It has a little bit too many weaknesses, but like I said, it does help remedy that with the amount of resistances it has. And the base defences could have done with being better, because if you look at how defensive it looks quite on the bulky side. So for that reason, I can't see why it's got defences that are quite bad. 251, not exactly going to be a hit taker. Unless you've got max HP and you like throw a lot into the defences, then it might be able to take hits pretty well. But thankfully, the three downsides listed here, they are not nasty, because they are all remedied by something, so I'm not going to focus a lot onto them. They are all perfectly reasonable and can be worked around with the right strategies. So moving on to the funnel part, which is the rating that I give this thing, and for the score I give this thing a 7 out of 10. Honestly, it is definitely my least favourite of the three starters of the Unova region. Its appearance is alright. It could have been so much better in my eyes, but it did come out decent in the long run. I just can think of a few things that could have done with being done with this thing. So that's all I've got to say about Emboar, so feel free to leave a comment below on your thoughts on this Pokemon, or make a video response if you want to also. So thank you very much for listening to this review, I hope you enjoyed it, and catch you guys next time.